Canon EOS VR Utility just released a major update. Now you can use it to post stabilized 3D VR 180 video shot on the Canon dual fisheye lens. It works with a gimbal setup like this and even controlled handheld movement like this. This is great for travel when you don't want to bring your heavy gimbal. We will also discuss some important updates in this release that allow you to use other editing software like Davinci Resolve to edit VR180 directly inside a VR headset. We will even cover how to bring VR180 video into professional software like BorisFX Mocha Pro or SynthEyes to do a more professional stereo tracking and further stabilize moving footage or do stereo VFX. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh and Hugh. We worked really hard to continue bring you the latest knowledge in XR filmmaking. It will help us a lot if you can subscribe and give this video a like, right Kimchi? EOS VR Utility just released a version 1.3. Here are the new updates. The biggest one is image stabilization. We talk about stabilization a lot on this channel because smooth, stabilized VR180 video is very important. Shaky VR video will make your audience motion sick. That is something you have to experience inside a VR headset to understand. So I prepare a test VR180 video with before and after stabilization with both handheld and gimbal setup so you can understand the problem better. Head over to this unlisted video right here, save the link in your watch later list and watch it inside your Meta Quest or PC VR using YouTube VR app. You can also download this video directly, link down in the description. As you can see, EOS VR Utility did an amazing job on stabilization, even with handheld video. But does that mean you can now handheld your R5C without a gimbal or a tripod? Well, not exactly. Before we dive in the software, let's talk about some filming techniques and common mistakes. First, if you can, use a gimbal. I have two in-depth tutorials here about gimbal and stabilization system. Watch it first. When using a gimbal, you should always turn on all lock mode and walk in a straight line. No turn. The camera height to the ground should be consistent throughout. Even with a gimbal and stabilization suit, up and down movement during walking will still make people motion sick. And the new version 1.3 algorithm is here to fix this problem precisely. It is still not perfect, but it is a nice and day different. For situation that you cannot use a gimbal and have to be handheld, here is the setup I will recommend. So now I'll try handheld stabilization. So I put string on my neck right here to push to make sure this gives me attention. The 1 point, 2 point, and 3 point, 3 point stabilization. And look at the screen, try to keep it level and centers. Roll camera. Make sure level. Handheld stabilization. It's obviously too low. Because like
you're right on my yeah, stomach. Right
yeah.
Now.
Okay, let's stop recording.
Definitely dark proof.
Yeah. So make sure that really important for VR you have to keep people eye line. So let's try again. Look at the leveler rolling. 3 point push pressure on the camera. And then I gotta walk slowly. You should use a solid shoulder strap like the Unity Falcam Mag Link right here. Use both hands to push the camera forward to create tension on the shoulder strap. When you walk, pay attention to the level display to make it as level as possible. Use a ninja walk to keep your movement slow and steady. As you can see, the result is acceptable. If you don't follow these walking techniques, EOS VR Utility cannot really fix all the problems. When you follow my setup and techniques, stabilizing the footage in software is very, very easy. First, download the latest EOS VR Utility version 1.3, link in the description down below. You see this new static menu right here? Not all video can be stabilized when a clip is shorter than 10 seconds or there's not many features to be tracked in the scene, the stabilization option will not be available. Select the clip you need to stabilize, go to the middle of the timeline when I am already in motion, turn on horizontal correction to fix the level. Before we use image stabilization, go to your menu right here and under processor, make sure you use your GPU. I have the Apple M2 Max right here, which in general is really fast at processing Canon footage. NVIDIA RTX series GPU also works great. Now turn on image stabilization and select trackability. You will see the progress bar and the progress circle right here to indicate the footage is being analyzed. In version 1.3, it also supports batch processing for all the shots. When turning on image stabilization, the lens mask option will be disabled. We will teach you how to add a lens mask back in later. Keep watching. There are two image stabilization options, trackability and blur correction. The English name is very confusing, but if you can read Japanese, it is actually very clear. When you are moving your camera in a straight line on a gimbal or handheld like here, use the trackability option. Basically, the trackability option is for moving camera shot. If your camera is stationary like here, I'm hand-holding my camera to do an interview of Kitty inside the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona, Spain, which does not allow tripod or gimbal, you will use blur correction to remove the camera operator's subtle movements. If you shot at Canon RAW light in 8K 60 frames per second on the R5C, I have another great news for you. In version 1.2, there is a trade-off between sharpening and noise reduction. Sharpening will bring back the noise. In version 1.3, sharpening is a lot smarter now. You have more options to fine-tune the sharpened result using strength, fineness, and threshold sliders. If you hate the digital noise in Canon, just crank up the NR slider to 3, dial in the sharpness setting to taste. Now you have the same low noise quality of shooting in HDVC, but with 8K 60 frames per second. No more Davinci Resolve or need video spatial denoising. It saves you hours of post-production and rendering time. In version 1.3, the horizontal correction is more powerful and accurate. It understands you are shooting upside down like this, and will apply the correct stereo correction to flip the image back like this. By the way, don't just flip stereo through the image in post, you will flip left and right eyes. Use the horizontal correction instead. In version 1.3, now EOS VR Utility support more new Canon cameras, including the Canon R6 Mark II. You can shoot 4K 60 frames per second for YouTube VR for half the price of the Canon R5C without dealing with Canon RAW. This is huge for run and gun creators who just don't have the time and the storage to deal with 8K RAW. YouTube VR recent update only support up to 4K 60 frames per second in VR180. So there's no point in shooting at 8K unless you are releasing on MetaQuest TV like I do. Matthew Cecilia from Lysel made a video about this for Canon. You can check out more info on the Canon R6 Mark II support on official Canon website. This is not a sponsored video by Canon or by anybody. So I am gonna be real with you. Canon R5C is an amazing camera and it is on sale right now with $300 less than the release price. R6 Mark II is about $1,000 cheaper, but if you are serious about filmmaking, getting a cinema grade camera with less than $4,000, you cannot beat that anywhere else on the internet. Cinema line Canon just looks better in both 2D and VR video. This is the reason why it is designed for professionals like us. Okay, back to the update. There's one more feature that changed the whole pipeline in VR180 post-production. Now, you can use Final Cut Pro X and DaVinci Resolve for VR180 editing thanks to the new render support. The old school 3D 260 top and bottom. In export under VR format, instead of picking VR180, you can now choose extend to 3D 260. The resolution of this video will become 8192x8192, and the final video will look like this. Final Cut Pro user, you can just edit this like how you edit any other 3D 260 video. For DaVinci Resolve user, now you can directly edit your VR180 video inside your MetaQuest VR headset without first converting it into 3D 260, which is a huge time saver. Since most of you follow this channel are switching to DaVinci Resolve for VR editing, so let me demo you how easy it is now. Just open up the latest DaVinci Resolve Studio, set your project resolution to the correct resolution, drop in the 3D 260 video output from the EOS VR Utility into the Resolve editing page, go to Fusion page on the clip you want to review inside VR headset. Assuming you are on a PC with a MetaQuest, connect to your PC using either AirLink or USB cable. Jump in your MetaQuest, like the MetaQuest Pro right here, and enable Oculus Link to open up the Quest software. Also, make sure you have Steam VR installed on your PC. If you are playing PC VR game, you should already have all of them installed. If you look at the media out node right now, you should have three docks. The last one will launch your MetaQuest automatically and push the 3D image into your VR headset. Now you can check all the stabilization we just did in EOS VR Utility inside VR, which is what you should do for stereo checking. The VR headset feature in Adobe Premiere 2023 or 2024 is completely broken right now. So the only way to review it in VR is by using DaVinci Resolve. Hey, if you appreciate in-depth tips like this one, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe if you are new here. If you see the handheld clip in VR, it is still very not stable even after EOS VR Utility new image stabilization processing. Thanks to the new 3D 260 top and bottom output, we can now further stabilize it using professional VFX software like BorisFX Mocha or the latest edition, Thin Ice. If you want to make $1,000 per day rate as a Hollywood level VR VFX artist, keep watching. I will show you the real professional workflow for VR180 stabilization. BorisFX Mocha Pro will work on both DaVinci Resolve and Adobe. Here, I drop the handheld clip in After Effects and drop in Mocha Pro as an effect. Under the View dropdown, you don't see any 180 side-by-side, but we do have 360 top and bottom. This is exactly what we are going to choose. Now, Mocha Pro, understand this is a 3D video. Open Mocha, go to Classic Mode. We are going to use the X-Blind tool to draw a shape around the door frame. In Mocha, you want to avoid checking reflective surface like glasses, but door frame is usually a great place to track. Make sure you turn on tracking left and right eyes. If you turn on 3D, you see 3D anagraph. Turn on surface 2 as well to follow the glass door to check if your tracking is solid or not. Now, check backward and forward. Go to reorient. Make sure Kitty is in the center of the 180 frame at all time, and also level the camera as we go. Now save and close Mocha Pro. Check render in module render and select reorient. Now your 180 footage is extra stabilized. Render out the clip and bring it back to Premiere. You can use the VR projection effects to convert it back to 180 side by side. The final render from Final Cut Pro X or DaVinci Resolve or After Effects will still be in 3D 360, top and bottom format. How can you convert it back to VR180 for YouTube and MetaQuest TV? Well, it turned out to be super easy. For the final release, you can use the Google VR180 Creator tool to convert the 3D 260 format into VR180. Select Prepare for Publishing and drop in the 3D 260 final render here. Make sure the input stereo layout is top and bottom and the input field of view is 360 video. Now hit Export. Google VR180 Creator 2 will crop the black from your video into correct 2:1 ratio for both YouTube VR and MetaQuest TV. Remember, you cannot really use the lens max when applying image stabilization in EOS VR Utility? Well, look at the final render from VR180 Creator 2. There is a lens mask edit to cover the lens. It is that easy. No extra work is needed. Now, you don't need Adobe Premiere to render VR180 video. You can use Final Cut Pro X, DaVinci Resolve, or any editing software of your choice, and the VR180 Creator 2 for final encoding. You can no longer download VR180 Creator 2 from Google, but you can still download it from me. I provide both Windows and Mac software version to download for free. Link in the description down below. If you appreciate me going above and beyond to help you, please follow me on Instagram and TikTok as well. We have more short tutorial coming there to help you get better in VR editing. So help me to help you by following. What about the EOS VR Premiere plugin? The new 1.3 version edits support for Canon R6 Mark II. You can edit RAW fisheye directly inside Adobe Premiere now. All the other update was already covered in detail in this video right here, so go check it out. There is no stabilization RAW editing ability just yet in Adobe Premiere plugin, unfortunately. EOS VR Utility comes a long way after 2 years of continued updates. It finally becomes the most powerful tool for VR180 creators who use Canon ecosystem. People doubt Canon will have the software ability compared to Insta360 or GoPro. Well, it took them a long time, but they are now the official king in VR180 filmmaking. And they are launching consumer VR180 and 360 hybrid camera right now. Learn more about this new Canon camera right here. And watch our free VR180 masterclass series right here. If you have not already, please support us by subscribing and hit the notification bell so you don't miss crucial information that will make you a better future content creator. I will see you in the next video, and see you in the metaverse.